So let's talk about how I got caught stealing in today's video and why it's so important to say the words that God wants you to say when he wants you to say them. Everyone is welcome in here from In That Word. And if you like what we're going to talk about in today's video, make sure you subscribe below the video and obviously hit the bell notification so you can get instant notifications and access every single time we produce a new video. So the last time I went to get my hair cut was about 6 weeks ago. It's a lot longer than the gap I normally take. But the fact of the matter is I went to get my hair cut from the normal guy that basically cuts my hair. And what basically happened was as I was basically leaving the shop, I basically gave him his money, said goodbye and all that stuff, the pleasantries, and I basically walked out the shop. Some point later in the day, I can't remember how long it was, if it was when I was basically walking to the car, when I was in the car, something along those lines, I basically put my hand in my pocket where the money was that I basically paid him, and I realized there was still some money left in the pocket. So I said to myself, I must have not given him the exact amount of money. Before you start thinking to yourself, oh well, you didn't really steal, wait for the punchline, because when I saw him next, something really vital happened and I need you to understand this, so wait around for that as well. I basically said to myself, you know what, I'm basically going to do is I can't be bothered in all honesty to go back to the shop right now. I see him quite frequently anyway, more frequent than every 6 weeks. So the next time I see him, I'm basically going to give him the money. So fast forward 6 weeks, and I remember just as I'm basically leaving where I live, the money that I'm supposed to owe him. But I say to myself, I can't remember how much it was. Was it this amount? Was it that amount? I really can't remember. This now brings a dilemma. I say to myself, well, I'm going to have an uncomfortable conversation with him and be like, well, last time I was here, I basically effectively stole from you, but I can't remember how much I actually stole. And as I thought about this more and more, I started to say to myself, I don't really want to have that conversation with him, especially if the amount is really small. At the end of the day, I didn't do it with malice or intent to shortchange him and all these different kind of things. Really and truly, it's only a little bit of money anyway. He probably wouldn't even mind. But in my spirit, I really felt led by the spirit to have that conversation with him. So I kind of said, okay, cool. And as I drove over to where I get my hair cut, as I sat in the chair, as he began to cut my hair, I thought about this more and more. As it got towards the end of the haircut, when I'm about to pay him, I'm thinking about it more and more. And I'm saying to myself, do I really want to have this conversation? We're talking about $1.50, thereabouts. And I'm basically just thinking about it more and more, saying to myself, all of the reasons why I shouldn't tell him. And notice what's happening now. An action that I took 6 weeks ago, which was not done by malice, there was no intent, had now been slowly creeping and turning into something that would have been done with ill intent, would have had malice in it, because I didn't want to have a conversation with him. And I started to realize at this point, if I don't have a conversation with this guy, if I don't say anything to this guy, then I'm effectively going to be stealing his money. Maybe not so much as I did the first time, but definitely now, more so this time, the second time. And I still was wrestling, saying to myself, well, it's just a small amount of money. It's not really that much of a big deal. We're talking about 20, 30, 40p here. Okay, like I said before, it's about 50 cents up to $1 max, those of you in America. So I'm deliberating and thinking about this more and more. Should I have this conversation? Should I not have this conversation? I probably won't even remember in the bigger scheme of things. And I'm just going to look like some idiot, some fool. Because I'm saying, oh yeah, you know, last time I forgot this this small amount of money. Here it is this time. And I'm probably going to look like some fool if I come up to him now and say, you know what? You know, last time I was here, I forgot this small amount of money to pay you. Here you go this time. I'm basically wrestling back and forth, should I really say something? So as we're nearing the end of the haircut, I basically just continue to think about it, continue to meditate on this. And the underlying feeling I continue to have is, I feel led by the spirit, say something, have a conversation. So just before he was finishing my haircut, I kind of recalibrate and get back to that whole mindset of, you know what, be led by the spirit. When you're led by the spirit, you're going to be led by the spirit into the right place and you're going to do the right thing. When you're not led by the spirit, when you ignore the leading of the spirit, you're going to fall into destruction. Which one do you want? And I say, you know what, I'm going to be obedient to God. I'm going to do exactly how I feel led in my spirit to do, and I'm going to have the conversation. So I start envisioning how I'm going to break it to him. And I decided that, you know what, as soon as I get out of the seat, I'm basically going to give him the money, walk over to my jacket, and as I'm walking back, I'm going to basically say it. And this was just the way I guess I could kind of build up the courage and the boldness really to have this conversation, which is probably going to make me look like a fool, in all honesty, in my mind anyway. So as I'm getting out of the seat, I find myself drifting toward the coat without giving him the money. But I say, you know what? Just give him the money and have the conversation. Be bold. There's nothing to be afraid of. At the end of the day, if you look like an idiot, if you look like some clown, you know you've done the right thing. So as I come out of the seat, I basically give him the money. And I say, you know what? The last time I was here, I didn't give you your full amount of money. And imagine what the guy says. He turns around and says, yeah, I know. And as I'm thinking about my mind, wow, you know, only for this little bit of money. I basically then said to him, yeah, I only remembered after I left the shop. And I'd obviously given him more money this time for him to basically take the bit that was in excess that I owed him. And as we had this quick conversation, he basically turned around and said, look, yeah, don't worry about it. And as I walked out the shop, as I went back to the car, and as I started thinking about this, and later on I spoke to my wife about this, because I was telling her and my daughter, basically, I was telling the whole family over breakfast, I was basically saying that, you know what, it's really important, it's really deep that you listen to the Spirit of God, because there's certain times the Holy Spirit is going to be telling you to do certain things or to say certain things. And at the time, we may be fearful. We may say, well, this doesn't make any sense, or the consequences in our mind are very small. We're talking about a small amount of money. But at the end of the day, one of the things I said and one of the things my wife said to me was really powerful. When she was relaying this to my daughter Anna at a later point in the day, she said something along the lines of, remember the story Daddy was telling us this morning, how he was basically saying he didn't want to say something, but he felt really led to say it. And after he said it, he realized that the guy actually knew. You have to go around and be an example and say, you know what, people are looking at you as a Christian and seeing exactly how you behave. Because at that present time, who knows if the guy who cut my hair all this time could have been thinking, well, this guy's a Christian, or whether he knows if I'm a Christian or not, he may be saying to himself, well, this guy's a thief. And maybe at some point in the future, as I try to minister to him, he may look at me and say, well, no, this guy shortchanged me before, and he didn't say anything the next time, so he stole my money. Even though I didn't have ill intention at the time, but because I never had the conversation later, that's the conclusion he went to. Not because I didn't say nothing at the time, but because I didn't say nothing after, that's the conclusion he's gone to, and he'd be justified. Even if I forgot at some point later on down the line. But the fact of the matter is, because I said something, he now knows for surety, for certain, if this guy makes a mistake, there's a likelihood, a strong likelihood, even if he's down the line, 6 weeks later, the next time he sees me, whatever it is, he will rectify the wrong. That's brownie points that I've accrued with it. So now think about this in your life. There's things you've probably said to people, or there's things you haven't said to people, and that may have led them down a certain path, that may have led them to certain conclusions, where they're thinking, so-and-so is like this, or XYZ says this, but doesn't do this. Certain times when you're fearful, when you're thinking, no, I don't want to say this, or I don't want to do this, just bear in mind that there are other people watching. And there's a reason why God will be encouraging you, and you'll be feeling led within to say certain things, because God can see the bigger picture. I, in my mind, was probably thinking that the guy didn't even remember, he didn't even know. But as soon as I said it, he said, yeah, I know. So if you think about it from that standpoint, if I never ever said anything to him, he could have went down the route of, yeah, Israel's a thief. He may seem to be this nice guy outwardly, but inwardly, he's a robber, he's a thief, he's a stealer. Because I said this, he can now look at me and say, you know what, this guy seems to be true to his word. And as we continue to have more interactions going forward, he can look at me and say, you know what, this guy seems to be genuine, because I've got this example in the back of my mind, and sometimes in the front of my mind, if he wants to draw it there and say, yeah, we had this situation. It was probably without ill intention and ill malice, but when he realized, or when he remembered, he rectified it. But when you go about your day-to-day life, just think about these kind of things. Be led by the Spirit of God. And if you like what we talked about in today's video, make sure you watch this video right here. It's a great video for you to watch based on what we've just covered in today's topic. So I'll see you on the next video. Thanks and take care.